Welcome back to Knowledge Talks, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your host, Tariq Al Barwani, along with our studio engineer, DJ Ayu, with you here live today on Oman Radio FM 90.4. Passion for photography started back in 2008. Today, his mission is to teach how to take quality photographs and edit them using tools that makes you a magician in photography. Who is he? Well, he has managed to train a number of students across Oman, so as created his own forum for his activities. The question again is, who is he? He is also a recipient of local and regional awards, mashallah, and today he is my guest. But the question again is, who is he? He is a great friend of mine by the name of Hussain Jasim Al Bahrani, a great photographer, and yes, a man with passion. And today he is my guest here at Knowledge Talks as he shares his passion and success to all of us, our audience at Knowledge Talks, ladies and gentlemen. Hussain, salamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thanks, Tariq. Thanks for having me. It's really glad to be with you in this show.
In fact, it's not only an honor, or it's not only the pleasure, but I am very, very happy to have you, Hussain. I have seen you a number of times, and whenever I look at you, I said, he is one of the unique individuals that I would like to invite because of the great things that you do, mashallah. And let me tell you one thing. Usually before I invite my guests, I go and I post about them and share that this is my next guest. And guess what? A lot of people like you too. MashaAllah. You have a lot of fans, MashaAllah.
Alhamdulillah.
Tell me the secret. I need to have that secret.
Secret is to be open with everybody, mashallah. To help everybody, mashallah. Support everybody. MashaAllah. This is the aim of what I started from.
MashaAllah.
And I'm continuing with it. Hopefully my God will help me to do that,
inshallah, mashallah,
to reach more, mashallah. To more people,
mashallah.
Share knowledge, this is mashallah. The main part of it, plus it helps me to know more people, learn more,
mashallah.
Yeah,
mashallah, that's a very noble characteristic, mashallah, and inshallah you always prosper in all that you do, Hussain.
Inshallah.
I'm one of your fans as well, and I really love all the great things that you do.
Thank you.
Your quality photographs that you have, and the great things you're doing for the society, mashallah. Now I'll tell you one thing, Hussain. What can you say about learning and teaching? So learning an aspect and then teaching about it, your experience and your feeling about it.
I follow one thing,
yeah.
Which is, I wrote it also in my website and my profile and everywhere, that yeah. is teaching. In teaching you will learn, and in yes. learning you will teach.
Exactly.
Because yes, if you started teaching, yeah. you learn a lot of things, because you are trying to understand everything. You want yeah. to deliver the quality.
True.
And you want to deliver more. And also, while you learning, you become knowledgeable. Then you will start do your own teaching if you have that passion, and if you are looking forward to make yourself more knowledgeable and help many people.
True.
If you have this, you will have the point to start, and you will do it successfully, and you will do it perfectly.
MashaAllah. Yeah. I respect that fully. In fact, why I asked you this question is because I viewed all of your pages and I saw that. I saw the great videos you have, I saw the great photos you have, and I saw your style is mostly about teaching people how to do things. Now, I'm your student, by the way.
Alhamdulillah.
I'm one of your students.
I'm happy
as well.
to hear that.
Because I like the great posts that you're putting and the tips that you give, MashaAllah. That they're very, very good. And as you said, teaching people, you also learn, because people will come and ask you a lot of questions.
Yes.
And from that, whether you know the answer or not, you will go into researching it, and then you'll find the answer, and then you'll teach them. And it's a circle activity, which at the end of the day builds a great wealth. So keep it up, and mashallah.
Inshallah.
Photography is your passion.
Yes.
Why photography?
It's actually from long time back.
Okay.
But I don't know why I didn't start it before that, before 2008. Photography, it's something beautiful. When I started till now, I was focusing in Oman, focusing in Muscat especially, and showing Oman in a better and beautiful way. I like the scenes here in Oman, so that leaded me to buy a camera, that leaded me to try and study more about photography. It was actually self-study, most of it. So it helped me to grow and show Muscat and Oman, like especially Muscat and generally Oman, in that beautiful scenes and beautiful way.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Yeah. What camera do you use?
Currently, I'm using Canon 5D Mark III, which is the latest one from that category. I'm trying, or I'm planning to buy another camera, which is second camera. Because sometimes, really, when I leave work or home without that camera, when I see any nice scene or the place where I didn't take a picture of it, I really go like really sad. So second camera means smaller one. I can take it with me in my laptop bag. And it has to be with me all the time.
What about these new mobile phones or these advanced mobile phones like iPhone, HTC and Samsung and all? They've got cameras built in with it. Are they not sufficient?
They are good for what they are, for the sensor size they have, for the minimum quality or the maximum quality or the limitation. They don't produce that quality of colors, lights. You cannot exceed more in editing there, the photos. You cannot print them big, if you like. You cannot do professional business with them. Basically, like, if you want to print a billboard of it, you cannot do that.
Okay, so you have limited use.
You have limited use, limited resolution, limited everything. If you go big, it will corrupt.
Okay.
So that's why you professional photographers heading directly for the professional cameras, bigger cameras, bigger sensors. You always, they will read every line before they buy a camera. They will read how fast is it. They will read the sensor size, how many lenses it can fit in, because every lens has different usage of it. This is the limitation of the phones.
Mobile phones,
You have one resolution, one size. You cannot exceed that size.
Yeah.
So that's why the camera is really important to have. Many people comes to me asking me, what camera should I buy? I will ask them two basic questions. You will use it. And what? Where the picture will go. So with that answers, I will tell them, go buy this camera or the professional camera, or keep using your mobile phone.
And also the mobile phones don't produce, I think, raw type images.
No, some new phones. They do produce raw files where you can edit them. But still, with that sensor size, with that small size, you cannot go more, you cannot exceed that limit.
What would be the examples of limits that a mobile phone has that a normal camera, for example, I know would be a zoom example?
One of the things is the lenses, the selection of the lenses. So one lens, it will give you, let's say, the wide angle view, which is if you are front of the Grand Mosque, well, let's say, you cannot capture the mosque from left to right, like the full angle of it
with a normal camera,
with the normal phone and the normal lens, or the normal camera. If you go and have the DSLRs or the other cameras, you will have a selection of wide angle lenses, where you can use this to have the full view of that mosque, with beautiful details, beautiful colors, and little of noise. This is important for photographers. Grains or noise, it will produce from the smallest sensors, like the phones. And you cannot get rid of them, because if you try to get rid of them, the details will disappear. Off the scene.
Is photography an addiction?
Yes. Plus money.
A lot of money,
You spend a lot of money in it, because it will become your passion. Plus, if you buy a quality tool or quality camera, quality lens, also you will consider quality tripods, quality accessories, quality computer, quality everything.
Wow.
Because you're paying for something big. You don't want to use for it a very cheap quality of accessories. So like the computer, like a lot of artists, photographers or drawers or what they will do, they will go directly to buying an Apple devices because it is they are Apple known to produce beautiful screens, beautiful colors. So they are, it will become like the second thing to buy after you buying your camera because you need to see that quality, what camera is producing.
That's what I noticed with a number of people is that once they buy camera one, they get into photography. The next step is they go and buy camera two or three or an advanced one. And then once they are settled with one camera, then they start going with different lenses.
Yes.
So it's a never-ending affair.
It's not really. Most of the people will stop depending on what category you are capturing.
Okay.
So let's give example of sport photography.
Yeah.
Sport photography means, let's say, football or cars, anything moving fast.
Yeah.
Okay. You will buy one lens or two only.
Yeah.
This is will be your selection of lenses. Why? Because that zoom lens will give you the exact picture that you're looking for.
Yeah.
And the wide angle lens will give you also the exact picture that you are looking for. You will not go more. You will not buy more. Because you are sufficient with it. Maybe you will upgrade your camera in, let's say, 5 years or 10 years, because every 2 years to 5 years, they will produce a new camera. New camera means having much speedier, and the function is really good and open in it, so you can reach to your goal faster and better.
Okay. You have learned about, mashallah, I can see from our discussion here that you have rich and vast knowledge, mashallah. You have done all this learning by yourself.
Yeah, let's say 95 or more than 95% I mean, is my
your own hard work,
it's
mashallah.
It's self-study, like reading, okay. reading. This is the three things.
Mashallah, which I really like that. Reading.
Yeah.
In fact, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first word that he was told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was Iqra.
Yeah.
So I respect that fully, and that's the power of any learnings. Now, can any person become a professional photographer? Can any person be Hussain?
This is a really tough question. Can any person? No.
Okay.
It will become like the artist or the singer or any other people, where it will be, first of thing, it will be as a gift from God that you have this eye and you have that passion, and you are willing to go more. Not everyone have this. Most of the people, like some examples from what classes I conducted before, they will come to ask me, I want more. I will tell them that you will not get it now. Not from the first shot, not from the second, not from the third, from maybe the million shot. Then you will be a pro photographer.
And experienced.
Yeah, but if they don't have
passion,
they will not continue. Means they will not go as a pro level.
Yeah.
They will stay as a normal level and the basic. Yeah. Then not everyone can handle this.
Yeah. So hard work is patience. Hard work is some of the characteristic that you recommend an individual to have in order to become professional at whatever they do.
Yes, and some of open pocket where you
so they can keep on buying things. Ouch. Yeah. In fact, I have a camera for myself. I'm not a photographer, but I just try to play with cameras. And I've got the SX50, the zooming Canon.
Yeah.
I can't change the lens, unfortunately. But I'm happy with it. Unless tomorrow I want to become like Hussain, I'll come to you.
Anytime.
Achievements. MashaAllah, you have received local and international awards.
Yes.
Please share with us about some of the events that you have attended, the programs, the competitions that you were in.
Actually, I join regularly the biggest photography competitions here in Oman, locally, which is usually conducted by Omani Photography Society,
okay.
which is really, I'm really thankful for them. every member, they are there. And also every year of National Geographic and Hamdan or Al Thani Awards, which is the biggest, competitions of photography.
Okay.
Plus, I used to join the FIAP, which is the photography society around the world, and I received many awards.
Okay, mashallah.
Locally or internationally. Local started from 2012, 2013, 2014. The biggest one was Ministry of Tourism. It was in 2012. I was the second place all over Oman.
Alhamdulillah.
And also Nokia has conducted a big competition here.
Discover Oman?
Yeah.
I saw you.
Yeah, it was from the...
I was just going to say that. So in my mind, I'm linking this. Someone I saw, some very, mashallah, enlightening individual. That was you.
He was busy talking and giving that speech.
That's what
that
I
really
do.
Good speech. Yeah,
mashallah. That's very good. That's very good.
Hussain,
mashallah. I'm very, very proud of the achievements you have done. And more attribute that I really, really like is the mission that you have at your core. You've got this passion, and you also have a mission to go and teach other people to become a great photographer, mashallah. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick break before we continue our interesting session today. Hey, welcome back to Knowledge Talk, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your host, Tariq Hilal Al-Barwani, along with our studio engineer, DJ Ahmed Al-Iremi, with you here live today on Oman Radio FM 90.4. Interesting discussion, interesting learning today with a professional photographer, Mr. Hussain Al Bahrani. Hussain, by the way, you have a very strong, nice, unique brand by the name of Shabek.
Yeah.
That's Shabek.
Yes.
What does it stand for and why Shabek?
You are the number 500, maybe, ask me about this. Shabek means, if you convert it, means connected.
Okay.
It started from early 2000.
Okay.
When I was searching for a username.
Okay.
Because I was like very, every time you will see me in the forums.
Okay. Mashallah.
And searching the sites. And so I was searching for something that unique.
Okay.
And you can get it everywhere in the internet.
Yeah.
So Shabek was the first thing.
Okay.
Shabek means connected.
Yeah.
So I was really connected everywhere.
So Shabakta, and you selected it.
Yeah.
And it's unique, by the way.
Yeah.
It's unique and it's nice. It goes with you very well. Because Shabek, connection, connecting people.
Yeah.
It's very good, mashallah. Talking about forums, you also have your own forum.
It's not a forum. It's a website.
Okay.
And a blog.
Okay.
Where I'm trying to cover everything that from courses or from knowledge or anything that I cannot express it in the smallest social media like Twitter or Instagram or Facebook.
Okay.
I will have it there in my website and in my blog.
Yep.
The website, I use it for two different things. Mm-hmm. The website itself, the portfolio mm-hmm. for the business
mm-hmm.
in case any company called me mm-hmm. To do some work with.
Okay.
The blog is to share knowledge mainly.
Okay.
I will put all the classes, I will put all the videos, I'll put all the pictures there. I will try to speak about it so people can learn and ask me like open discussion there.
What are the different platforms that you have or you use? So you've got the Instagram, you have your Facebook.
Yeah, mainly it's Instagram for now because people or photographers love Instagram and it's easier. You will just open it and see one picture and that's it.
Yeah.
Okay. Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and my website mainly.
Okay.
I wanted to convert to Google Plus, but in Oman, Google Plus is kind of
not popular.
Not popular.
I think it's all over the world is not popular.
Yeah. No, some people in US and Britain and Asia they're still using Google Plus. They don't use Facebook.
Okay.
Yeah, and some big companies they're still using the they like the blog or the forum of the Google Plus, where it's open discussion and easier to find stuff and connect with people.
Compared to Facebook?
Yeah.
Okay. And so you have a Twitter account, you've got an Instagram, and you've got your website.
Yes.
Which of them is your popular one?
Instagram.
Instagram is your popular account.
Yes.
Could you please share to our audience all your accounts, the addresses?
Sure. Everywhere is Shabek, Shabek.
Atri.
Yeah. I use YouTube actually also.
Obviously, you use YouTube.
I'm uploading some videos there.
Okay.
But I don't use it that much. I'm trying to cover and do more.
Okay.
And because YouTube needs a different way of making videos,
mm-hmm.
you have to do it professionally. You have to do it not that long. You okay. have to make people understand, but not get bored.
Okay.
So it needs some techniques to reach to audience and make yourself popular. My website is HussainAlBahrani.com.
Okay. Yeah. HussainAlBahrani.com. You mentioned that you do business.
Yes.
What business do you do?
Two things. One is conducting classes.
Okay.
For photography.
Okay.
And photo editing.
Okay.
It's two different areas. It's connected to each other,
okay.
but not a lot of people would like to know about photo editing
okay.
while they're starting. Mm-hmm. They will go for photography, the basic photography. Then they will go to the second level. The other thing is I shot a lot of for business, like some for food restaurants.
Okay.
I shot some portraits for companies
mm-hmm.
And some events.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. So you people contact you through your website and your social platforms that you have or that
yes.
which you've shared right now
yes,
to get hold of you.
Yeah.
Now, talking about so you explained to us about the cameras that you use and the kind of photos that you've taken. What tools do you use?
In terms of softwares?
Yeah.
Softwares, for now, I use so many softwares because I like to experiment.
Okay.
Mainly it's Lightroom, then mm-hmm. Photoshop.
Okay.
This is the main two programs.
Lightroom and Photoshop.
And Photoshop.
Okay.
I use a different number of different plugins, which mm-hmm. is it's like extras. You can load them inside those programs, or mm-hmm. you can load them separately.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, I use some HDR special software for HDR
mm-hmm.
to compile all these exposures.
Mm-hmm.
All
what
these pictures.
HDR stands for?
High dynamic range.
Okay.
Where you shoot three or two or more pictures and then
mm-hmm.
compile it to each other
mm-hmm.
and get really high dynamically lights
okay.
in everywhere in the picture.
Okay.
Where you cannot get it with one picture.
Okay.
So you can do that in Photoshop, but some other programs they are specially for that.
Yeah.
I use also another program for compiling the panoramic shots. Panoramic mm-hmm. means you shoot two shots
okay.
or more,
and
then combine it together.
Okay.
Photoshop, Lightroom, other programs can do that,
mm-hmm.
but sometimes if they fail, I have another solution.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, Lightroom, is it an Adobe product?
Yes.
Okay. And would you agree that it's a light version of Adobe Photoshop?
It's a light version. It's mainly made for photographers.
Okay.
You can do a lot of things in Lightroom.
Okay.
It has its limits, but still it's very powerful program.
Mm.
And I did many of my powerful pictures mm. only in Lightroom. Mm. And I didn't need to use another softwares or I didn't need to move it in Photoshop. So photographers, mainly the beginners, I recommend Lightroom to start with
mm-hmm.
because Photoshop is a little bit difficult to
okay.
understand.
Okay.
It has a lot of tools to use. And most of the tools are not really for photographers because
mm.
Photoshop, as people will know, it's not only for photographers.
Mm.
It's everything from 3D mm. makers to video to everything.
Yeah.
So Lightroom is really powerful and light and good for beginners.
Good for beginners. Now, photographs, when someone takes a camera and click, takes a photo, are nice photos. You would use the tools to play around with the photos? There's some kind of things that you can use those tools, like Photoshop, Lightroom, whatever, to add some kind of flares or so that makes the photo, you know, magical kind of thing.
Yes, you can do that. It depends on the way you are using or you are producing your photos.
Mm-hmm.
Most of us, they're using these programs to make the picture pops. Pops means get more colors, more contrasty mm-hmm. photo,
mm-hmm.
Plus adding some lights, some exposure of it for it, mm-hmm. brightness.
Okay.
Because the camera, the thing with the camera, even if you buy 1,000 riyal camera or 2,000 riyal camera, mm-hmm. it will not give you the high dynamic range.
Mm-hmm.
What you are seeing in with your eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Your eyes came from God, mm-hmm. and it's like really powerful thing to see with.
Alhamdulillah.
The camera cannot simulate that at all.
Yeah.
It has some limit, so that's why photographers go with the other method mm. where they're compiling different exposures or they're trying different techniques mm. that maybe some of the beginners, they will not know about it while they're starting. Yeah. So that's why this is one of the knowledge that I'm trying to also deliver it to the people so mm. they understand it
mm-hmm.
and take it forward with their photos.
Would you agree that beautiful photos, it's not about the camera, but it's about the photographer?
Yes. Camera cannot produce you that really beautiful photo from that one shot
mm.
because the quality or the beautiful photograph, it comes from so many things.
Mm.
It comes from preparation. It comes from thinking of the photo, mm. thinking of the scene, how it will come. All this, camera cannot do it for you.
Mm.
Camera can see one thing, can see light.
Yeah.
You can see what? You can see the scene, you can see the colors, you can see the environment, you can see everything. Camera cannot see that.
Okay.
That tools will help you to produce the final product, but it will not help you to make it.
Okay. Yeah. I've noticed, apart from photography, which you are doing it very well, mashallah, you also do videography.
Videography in sense of not capturing the videography itself.
Okay.
I did a lot of time lapses.
Okay.
Which is moving pictures, moving mm-hmm. scenes, and some hyperlapses also. The big one I did, it's about Muscat,
mm-hmm.
and it's there on YouTube if anyone can or would like to watch it.
What is the name of the video?
It's Muscat hyperlapse and mm-hmm. time lapse.
Very good. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. Muscat.
Time lapse and hyperlapse.
That's a video that you can see that has been done by Shabek. And I tell you one thing, your eyes will pop up too. Mashallah.
Yeah, in that video, I covered most of the places in Muscat.
Okay.
And one of the target and goal that I will do, inshallah, is to uh-huh. cover all Oman.
Mashallah.
With the same techniques.
Okay.
Yeah, it's really difficult to achieve.
Mm-hmm.
I end up with 10,000 photos.
Wow.
Because from one scene, let's say you will take maybe 300 photos to 500
mm-hmm.
from one scene only.
Okay.
And that scene, that 500 photo, it will be converted to 10 seconds only.
Wow.
Of watching.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
It's
beautiful.
It's beautiful. Creative. It's different to the eye.
Yeah.
It will give you movements. It will give you really good scenes.
Okay. MashaAllah. That's really great. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick break as we return to our session today. Welcome back to Knowledge Talks, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your host, Tariq Hilal Al-Barwani, along with our slow engineer, DJ Ahmed Al-Aremi, with you here live today on Oman Radio FM 90.4. Hussain, lovely learning that we have all learned from you. Great achievements that you have done and learning and knowledge that you've been contributing to the society. Now, the question that I have for you is, I want to be a photographer. Someone listening to our radio right now says, you see, I want to be a photographer. What would be the steps that you would advise for someone to start into the photography and then for them to become professional photographers?
There are many things to do, but before I start, they need to understand one thing. It doesn't come from, as I said, from the first or second or the third shot. The success cannot come with the first try. You have to fail, you have to try, you have to do so many experiments. You have to accept challenges also, because challenges means you become like addicted to it.
Yeah.
So you leave a lot of things and focus only on that one thing. So focusing on one thing means photography.
Okay.
You will reach. Plus, you need to read more. You need to follow more people that better than you. You need to make it first. You need to make it a hobby. From hobby, it will start gradually to a professional. If you're good at it, and if you want to cover many things in photography, plus the things you need to learn is always try to get new techniques.
Mm-hmm.
New techniques means by reading not the same sites, try different sites if you if you like to reading.
Yeah.
If you like to watch videos, like let's say in YouTube, follow one. Don't follow one person only. Try to follow as many as you can, because everyone has his own way or own unique way to deliver a message.
Okay.
So you will need to know what which one it's suiting you and which one to follow more.
Okay.
You cannot become a professional in this in 1 month or 2 months or 3 months. So you need to work more. You need to understand your gear. You need to read more about your gear, because you don't want to be on that place where a professional company asks you to come and photograph their CEO, and you don't know how to use your lights or your camera or or lenses. So you need to be prepared. You cannot be prepared by not reading.
Okay.
So you have to read, then you will be understand. You understand what to do next.
Yeah, and you need to keep yourself always updated on the latest tools.
Yes, that's why you follow different people. You read different books, different magazines.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who do you follow?
Millions of people.
Wow, very good. And that's why you've got millions of knowledge, mashallah, in all the activity that you do. Now, tell me one thing. So that is one is to learn about photography. And then so someone takes up the photography as a passion, and then they grow to become professionals. What about the career in photography?
You can. And there is a way to do that with photography, because photography has so many categories, and everyone, every shop, every place needs a photograph, especially now. Why now? Social media is like growing like fast.
Very fast. Every day a new platform comes out.
Yes. And most of it needs photo. Most of it needs videos.
Yeah.
Different company will need different thing.
Yeah.
A CEO will need a picture of him. A profile picture.
Yeah.
You can start with that.
Yeah.
You can build your career with shooting headshots, which is CEO headshots. You can do that. This is one of the thing, one small thing to start with. Other thing is to shoot, let's say, the hotels, hotel room, hotel lobby. Try your best while you on vacation. You can do that. You on that hotel, take a picture of that room and try to produce it in the way where it's really called a quality picture. Then try to show it the hotel itself. Maybe they will like it. Maybe you can start career from there.
Mashallah, I really like that.
So it's a lot of things, a lot of ways to do that. And the thing is, you need to read more, because you cannot start something that while you don't know how to start with it, or you will fail in the mid of doing it. So try your best. Try different things, different categories. See where which category is really suiting you. Which category don't make your pocket empty.
Okay.
Like while you're starting, and the like if you're a beginner, you don't want to go you don't want to go crazy and buy the expensive gears. Try slowly, gradually, and you reach to your point.
MashaAllah, you have a lot of fans, by the way, and one of your fans sent a message right now. His name is Father Rasadi, and he's very, very happy to have you on air. He says he just wants to ensure that you go dinner for him with him as well. Hey, what are your future plans and goals?
Actually, many. One of them I already spoke about it, which is a project I'm doing, hyperlapse and time lapse about Oman. The other thing, I'm middle of it now, which is writing my own book. My first book, inshallah, about photo editing.
Okay.
The second one will follow that, which is will be hopefully about photography. The thing is, why I'm consider books. I want people to read more.
Very good.
This is one thing. Second thing is the Arabic content is very less, especially in photography or photo editing. The books you find in the stores, it's either English and then translated to Arabic, or you will not find.
Yeah, true.
So
true.
I'm trying to reach to that and be one of the known book writers here about this subject.
Inshallah.
Inshallah, we'll reach to it.
Inshallah. Yeah. Anything you wish to share with our audience before the end of our program today?
First of thing, I will thank you for having me.
The pleasure is mine.
It was wonderful 1 hour.
Alhamdulillah.
It went fast. Second is, as I said before, success doesn't come very easy. Accept challenges. Read. Follow people that better than you. Watch a lot of videos. If you don't like to read, you can. The internet is easy now. You can find anything you want. You can build up your knowledge from the internet. You don't need to call all your friends and ask them all the 1,000 questions. You can ask our uncle Google.
Google, yeah.
And take it to passion and go for it.
Beautiful advices, great, in fact, and valuable advices from one of the greatest photographers we have in Oman, and who will, inshallah, soon have his book. Don't forget. And by the way, when you have the book, get me a copy.
Sure.
Don't forget me as well.
You will get me.
MashaAllah. Thank you very much for joining us today on Oman Radio FM 90.4 to share about your photography journey and success. And I would like to take this opportunity to wish you the very best and success in everything that you do, inshallah.
Inshallah. Thank you very much.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of our program for this week. I hope you all had an intriguing time with us. Let us catch up again next week on Tuesday, same time at 5 p.m. for a knowledge session. I'm your host, Tariq Hilal Al-Barwani, along with our studio engineer, DJ Ahmed Al-Arami, wishing you all a happy and a pleasant week. Ma'a salama.